Hey, what's up, guys? Before I show you my wood-burning fireplace insert, let me first show you a few pictures that I found of where my fireplace was and where I have now taken it to. Roll the pictures, Johnny. So, now that you've seen the pictures, this is kind of the final result. Got our pictures up top, got a mantle, painted it, all that good stuff. Here's my fireplace insert. I bought this from Northern Tool and Equipment down in Greenville, South Carolina. Trying to build up some heat right now. I just put in some new logs. So, let me just close this back up. This is a pretty good unit, very economical. The only thing I am disappointed in is the fan at the bottom. Not powerful enough, doesn't move enough air, I think. This here, this plate, the face plate or whatever you call it, I had to build that myself. I used to work at a fabrication shop, and I just took some quick dimensions around my profile of the insert, and then I added some footage out to the side, curved it over, and then we had a laser CNC that cut it for me. And then, I just painted it up, and here we are. But I'm really impressed with the glass, self-cleaning glass there. You can always see the flame. The dampener works really well. See, it's open now, so if I close it, you can see that it's a good tight seal. It starts to die and kill down the flame. And you can run it all night. It's giving off a lot of heat right now just from sitting, not even running the fan really. But like I said, I just put in some new wood, so I'm trying to crack it and get it going again there. But this fan is just, it's loud, it's cumbersome, it only comes out the right. Even if you plug it in on the left, you don't really have a choice, left or right. Just, let me see if I can show you. It's just, that's on low. Of course, that doesn't sound bad at all, but it's just rattly. I've got wedges up under it trying to stop the rattle, but it doesn't seem to work. And let me turn it up on high. I mean, who wants to listen to that all the time, you know? That's just awful. And it doesn't even, like, for all that noise, you think it would really put out some air, but it just doesn't. I usually take a fan. I've got a fan out in the camper, and I'll use it to kind of help blow through it. Just haven't got it yet. This is my first burn. Let me show you. I got a typical napkin. I mean, look. We're just barely blowing that. I mean, look at this. We're barely even blowing it. I mean, it's... the heat that is coming out is boiling over with heat. It's really, really hot. But it's just, I mean, look at this. It's nothing. So I'm just really disappointed in that aspect. But like I said, I take a little high velocity fan. I put it right here. Put my high velocity fan right there. Blows it up under it. And then it just bubbles out just this crazy amount of heat. But this is my insert. If you guys have any more questions, you can probably find them on Northern Tool and Equipment. But hope that helps. Really love it. Wood burning is great. Very economical. You can find wood everywhere, and then you just burn it for free. So, you know, I really do recommend it. As long as you don't mind loading wood and grabbing some wood, you know. Not really a big deal. Burns about a pile a night. And so far, we've been really, really happy with it. So thanks for checking out my channel. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. How about a thumbs up if you did? And we'll catch you later.